Hello Python students, in this lecture we will see two new concepts, namely escape characters and use of codes supported by the Python language. Let's start with escape characters. For example, I want to print a statement like "It's a beautiful day." As you can see, I've started with a single quote and I end this particular string with a single quote, which is a valid syntax for a print statement. Let's execute. It says invalid syntax because over here it has this apostrophe and computer doesn't differentiate between this apostrophe and the single quote which we usually use to start a string or stop a string. Because of that, a computer starts a string with this quote and ends it with this particular quote, which is actually the part of that sentence. Now the question is, how to solve this problem? One easiest solution is to make it is, and it will work. But I don't want to do that. I want to keep it like this only. And this particular problem or this particular error can be fixed using escape character. Escape character is a mechanism which allows us to add those specific characters or those specific symbols in a string in print, which usually we cannot do, as you can see over here with this single quote. Escape character is returned using a backslash followed by the character which you want to insert in that particular string. In this case, I want to insert a single quote. Hence, I should use backslash before that single quote. As you can see, as soon as I insert a backslash, even the color of that particular statement changes immediately. Now you can observe this backslash followed by a single quote has a different color because now these two characters are not considered as separate characters. Computer will translate this particular character as a single entity and it will replace it with a single quote as we want it, just like this. It's beautiful day. It's a beautiful day. And this particular character is referred as escape character. Let's try one more example. Print. Now instead of single quotes, I want to use double quotes. As we have seen earlier, with respect to print, it is absolutely okay to use double quotes instead of single quotes. We are from IIT Madras. Once again, computer reads it as starting of the string and this double quote as ending of the string. Then it's not able to process this particular term IIT in between, followed by starting of a string and ending of a string. Because of this, computer is giving us an error which says invalid syntax. This escape character will rescue us from this particular invalid syntax error. Backslash followed by double quote. Once again, backslash followed by double quotes. Now we are getting the expected output. We are from, in double quotes, IIT Madras. This is related to single quotes or double quotes. What if I want to do something little bit different than this? For example, print, my name is Omkar, space, I am from Pune. If we print it, it will print correctly. But what if I want to give additional space between these two sentences? Currently, there is only one space in between these two sentences. But I want to separate these sentences even further. The simplest way could be to add more spaces, but it's not a good practice. So what to do? Usually we use tab to give these extra spaces. But how to use that in the Python language? Let's retain this code and copy it. Instead of this space, if I use something like backslash t. T stands for tab. If you can observe the last two lines of the output, here there was only single space. But now you can see more gap between these two sentences. If we add one more t over here, it will put more gap between these two sentences. And now we do not even have to give multiple spaces between two sentences. So this particular escape character is called tab. Now there is a sufficient gap between these sentences. But still I am not happy with this particular code. I want to print these sentences on different lines. A straightforward way is to remove this particular sentence from here and add it as a fourth print statement. But we can avoid that by placing one more escape character called backslash n. N stands for new line. Let's execute this code. Now you will see the first sentence is getting printed on the third line, whereas next sentence is getting printed on the fourth line in the output, even though these two sentences are actually written as a part of same print statement. This is happening because of this specific escape character called backslash n, which refers to new line. Before moving to next concept, let me give you a small exercise. Let's copy these two lines. I will change this single quotes to double quotes and remove this escape character symbol. Similarly, I will make these single quotes and remove this particular escape character. Oh, there is spelling mistake here. Alright, that's not an important part. The exercise is, I will not execute these two lines. It's up to you to execute these two lines, see the output and figure out why the specific output is coming like that. This is very important concept of strings. But as it's very simple, I am leaving it up to you guys to study on your own. Next part of this particular lecture is use of quotes supported by the Python language. We have already seen the use of single quote and double quote for strings. X is equal to single quote, this is a string. Y is equal to double quotes, this is also a string. Print X, print Y. As expected, it will print these two strings. So far, it was working. But for example, I want to write a third string which says first line, second line, third line, print Z. It says EOL while scanning string literal. EOL stands for end of the line. It says end of the line while scanning string literal. When computer starts scanning this third line, it starts with Z is equal to single quote first line. It is still looking for the closing of this single quote, which it is not able to find as part of this third line. That's why we are getting this particular error, which means this single quote is useful only when our string is stored in a single line. If we divide the string in multiple lines, then we cannot use single quote. Let's try double quotes instead of that. Still, we are getting the same error. Now the question is, how to handle this kind of a string? In order to store such a string which is distributed over multiple lines, is stored using three quotes. Let's print and try. As you can see, it says first line, second line, third line. Similarly, we can keep adding as many lines as we want. Fourth line, fifth line, and so on. So now we know there are three different types of quotes which are supported by Python language. Single quote, double quote, and then triple quotes, which we studied just now. And it is used for storing multi-line strings. There is one more advantage is using these triple quotes. Earlier we have studied, if we use hash, then computer ignores that particular line from execution. It did not print x and y. It printed only the variable z, but ignored variable x and y, which we printed in line number 8 and 9 because the use of this particular character hash. As we know, hash is used to comment a particular code, which means that particular line will be considered as a comment, not a part of Python program. But what if I want to give a comment which occupies more than one line? I can always say comment 1, comment 2, comment 3, and so on, and it should work. But adding this hash every time is not an optimum solution. A similar problem can be solved once again using these triple quotes, because once again, whenever we use triple quotes, it becomes a comment in Python. So today we have studied a new type of quotes called triple quotes, and they can be used for two different purposes. First, to define a multi-line string, and second, to give a multi-line comment. Thank you for watching this lecture. Happy learning.